also insufficient water level leads to higher rain flow. By that, yield of rice reduces, and also there is no evidence of an automation system in Sri Lanka to control the water level of paddy field. Therefore, the objective of this study was design and develop a smart water monitoring and control system for paddy fields for easy and precise water control. There were three steps in the methodology: automatic spillway, automation, and remote control. Non-corrosive materials were used to fabricate the automatic spillway because the half of the automatic spillway is under the water. And these electronic components were used to fabricate the control system and also to power the control system. Before going to fabricate the final structure for the automatic spillway, these two prototypes were fabricated. So, by studying these prototypes, both these structures were fabricated by using foam board. And also, the gate mechanism were also same in these both cases. Both gates were sluice gates. And also, both gates were driven by using a stepper motor. After studying both prototypes, two weaknesses were identified. The water leakage was very high because of the nature of a sluice gate. It was very difficult to apply a water sealing mechanism with them. And also, although foam boards are not soluble in water, physical strength of the foam board was not sufficient enough to tolerate the soil stress coming from the field when it is established in the paddy field. But the gear mechanism used to fabricate these both designs worked well. So this gear mechanism was used to fabricate my final design. Here the schematic diagram of the final design. Based on the prototypes, the sluice gate mechanism was neglected. A flexible hose fixed on a PVC pipe was used to control the water level. In this chamber, the stepper motor is fixed and the shaft of the stepper motor coming out from through this razor. After that, this shaft goes through the nut which is fixed on the top of the flexible hose. Then the nut also fixed and the shaft also fixed. Only possibility is to move the flexible hose up and down. This flexible hose can be contracted and also extended. And here is the cross-sectional view of the design, and here is the top-up view of the design. Here the schematic diagram of the internal view of the automatic spillway. This flexible hose goes up and upwards and downwards according to the movement of the stepper motor. If the stepper motor rotates clockwise, the gate rises up, the flexible hose rises up. If the stepper motor rotates anti-clockwise, the flexible hose lower down. With this mechanism, the water level can be kept at a specific height because the water level should be kept in different proper stages varies. So, and also water sealing mechanism also very easy with this mechanism. Here's the final view of the automatic spillway. The outer cover is made up with stainless steel, and also the outer cover is porous in order to drain the water inside. The automatic spillway should be buried up to this point in order to take the precise water control. In order to drive the gates up and down, both sluice gates and also the flexible hose, the stepper motor was used. This stepper motor needs 12 volts in order to get function well. And also, in order to make the connection between the Arduino Uno board, the stepper motor driver was used. In order to detect the water level of the paddy field, a water leveling mechanism was designed. So for that, an ultrasonic sensor was used. This ultrasonic sensor was fixed inside an end cap of PVC, then that end cap was fixed on top of the PVC pipe. Then the distance from the ultimate sensor to the bottom is constant. Therefore, the current water height can be derived by subtracting sensor reading from the constant distance between the ultrasonic sensor and the bottom. In this case, it was 50 centimeters. Here is the flowchart of the control system. The sensors detect the water level of the field and it sends signals to the Arduino microcontroller. According to the uploaded program, it decides whether to rise up the flexible hose or lower down the flexible hose. And also, in order to make the connection between the farmer and the paddy field, a GSM module was used to make the connection between the control system and farmer's mobile phone. Here is the flowchart of the algorithm. When it's power on, the program is initialized. After that, it reads the sensor readings. Then after, it compares the sensor readings with the set values. Based on that, it decides whether to rotate the stepper motor clockwise or anti-clockwise. Then the rising and lowering of the flexible hose happens. Here is the schematic drive of the control system and also the control system. Here is the how the message transmission happened between the farm and the control system, that means with the paddy field. So automatically, when the water levels comes up and maximum levels and the minimum level, it automatically sends messages to the farmer. And also, the farmer can know the states of the paddy field and also the current available water height by just typing states. And then, within a fraction of a second, the machine, the design system replies the farmer by telling both the gate person and the available water height. And also, it can instruct the farm can instruct the machine by just typing up and down. The system should be, when it is established in the field, the lower plot of the paddy field was selected, and then the hole was prepared in order to bury the automatic spillway, and the automatic spillway was buried, and then the sensor was established in the middle of the field. In order to calibrate the sensor, actual water heights were measured with relevance to the sensor readings, 3 cm and 5 cm. According to the results, the automatic spillway functions at optimum level, and also fixation of the automatic spillway was very easy, and also the water leakage was very negligible, and also there were no any blockages notices. And also the main advantage of this system, the farmer can decide whether there is a damage on the dikes or not according to the frequency of text messages. Please consider out the video. Initially, the water level is low in the field. It automatically rises up the flexible hose. Here, what you see inside. Meanwhile, it should send a message to the farmer. Yeah, farmer got the message when the water level is very low. And also that now the farmer can instruct to rise up the flexible hose if farmer desires. And also when the water level comes to the maximum level, this automatically system lower down the flexible hose. Yeah, now also the farmer got the message because the water level is high now. And also, now the farmer can rise up the flexible hose by instructing on it, just stepping up. Yeah, farmer can know the available water height and the gate position by just typing state and send to the mobile phones of the control system. Control system responds within a second. According to sensor calibration values, there is no significant difference between the sensor readings and the actual water heights. And the average water, as the conclusion, average water heights for the sensor reading 3 centimeters and 5 centimeters per 2.96 and 4.86 respectively. According to the conclusion, the smart water quality and control system can be applied, a control system tested and designed successfully. As a recommendation, the design system can be applied for the benefits. These are the references.